Hello friends, so today we are going to talk about conduction heat transfer due to or through cylindrical walls. Okay, so first of all, consider a cylindrical surface or a container. Suppose this is a cylindrical object and it has an outer surface and inner surface, and the radius for inner surface would be ri and for the outer surface it is ro. Okay, now how does heat transfer through this cylinder? So heat transfer through these walls. These are called the cylindrical walls. Okay, heat is being transferred through these. So we have to find out the value, that how much heat that it could transfer through these walls. And it is very basic and easy to find out the value of Q for this cylindrical wall. And in the same video, we will find out the heat transfer through spherical wall. Okay, so suppose the length for this is equal to L. Okay, and heat transfer would be Q. Now first of all, we will write down the Fourier's law. So what is it? Q is equal to Ka dT over dx. Okay, and negative sign. Now here variable thing is dr. Here radius is varying, so the differential would be with respect to dr. So we'll write it down again as Ka dT over dr. Now it is very easy to derive for it. So first of all, we have to find out what is the value of A. What would be the area? So area of cylinder is 2 pi rh, we all know. So minus k, 2 pi, and radius r, and length or height h. So that would be L. And dt over dr. This is Q. But we have to find out Q in terms of difference of temperature to RTH. Okay. So what is RTH? It is the equivalent resistance. So how we could find it out? So first of all, rearrange this whole equation in terms of R, dr and T. So we have to do this. We have to apply a unitary method. So Q upon 2 pi R L, 2 pi and L and K. And here 1 upon R. That would be equal to minus dt. And here dr, it would be equal to dr. Now we have to integrate this equation so that we could find out the exact values for this equation. So integrating it. Okay. Now here we can see that radius is varying from ri to ro, or say it is r1 to r2. That would be much easier. So r1 to r2, and temperature varies from temperature T1 to T2. Temperature T1 to T2. Now integrating this equation, and we will find out the value of Q. So here we can see that here Q upon 2 pi LK is constant. So Q upon 2 pi LK is taken outside, and integral R1 R2 dr over R, and here it is dt from T1 to T2. Now integrating this, Q upon 2 pi LK, and this will be log R. But here you have to keep one thing in mind, that you have to take natural log, not this log, because the base for this natural log is e, and this for this it is 10, and natural log is used in whole thermodynamics and in all the HMTs, but you have to use this logarithm for the mathematics only. So keep in mind that you have to take natural log. So natural log ln r, and it is varying from R1 to R2, and this is T from T1 to T2. Now we have to put the values again, limits. Now applying limits, then Q upon 2 pi LK, and here it would be R2 minus ln R1. This is, and here temperature would be T2 minus T1. Now here we could we know the formula for property of natural log is log A minus log B is equal to A by B. Okay, so here we could apply this. So this would be ln R2 upon R1 Q upon 2 pi LK is equal to T2 minus T1, and this is negative sign. We could interchange it so that the negative sign is balanced. So T1 minus T2, and here Q upon 2 pi LK, we could interchange these as well. So ln R2 upon R1 and Q to 2 pi L K. Now when we remove log sign from this side, or say taking anti-log, then here we will find out the E, log E, the base of E over here, and this base E would be over here. So this would be R2 upon R1 be equal to E raised to the power T1 minus T2 2 pi LK upon Q. But this is not required. If you want to find out the thickness, then this is the formula for this, to find out the thickness of the it is the formula for finding out the ratio of both the radii, but we are not required to find out the ratio of these radii, so we have to find out the value of Q. So for finding out Q, we will get back to this equation again, okay, or this equation. From this equation we could find it out that Q is equal to T1 minus T2 divided by natural log R2 upon R1 whole divided by 2 pi LK, and this is the equation for heat transfer by cylindrical wall. If there are a number of walls, then we have different formulas for that we will add other surfaces like I'll explain it now. Suppose a cylindrical wall, okay, this is a cylindrical wall, it is made up of steel. Now it is insulated by another insulator, again one another insulator. Now suppose here temperature is T1 and outside temperature is T3, T1, T2, T3, okay, the outside temperature is T3. Now how we could find out the heat transfer Q? So for this Q would be equal to T1 minus T3 whole upon, now we have to put the values that would be, or we have to find out separately RTH. So for that we have to write it down as natural log R2 upon R1, and 2 pi LK could be taken outside, 1 upon 2 pi L, sorry, 2 pi L, not K, okay, because K would be different for all the materials, K1, K2. Again, for adding ln R3 upon R2 and whole divided by K2, and this is this will be moving on the same way. And if there is heat transfer due to convection, then we have to add one more thing, that would be 1 upon HA, and that would be area, that would be 2 pi LK, 2 pi LH, sorry, 2 pi LH. The area will be 2 pi r into l length, and sorry this would be the heat transfer due to convection as well. You will better understand these equations in questions. When I'll do questions, then I'll explain this to you, and the next videos I'll cover the questions as well. Now we will find out the heat transfer due to sphere, solid sphere. So this is same as the cylinder as we have did in the previous part. So here the area would be the difference. So the area would be 4 pi r square, and if you'll put the value for area of this sphere, then you'll find out the different output for this. So I'll do this for you, but if you want to do this by yourself, then you can do it as well. So first of all, write out the formula for Q is equal to, for Fourier's law, so Q equal to minus Ka and dt over here dr. Again here radius is varying, so we will take dt over dr. Now putting the values again, Q is equal to minus K again A 4 pi and R square and dt over dr. Now rearranging these equations, and we will find out the formula of Q. So I will write it down the formula for this, the exact formula, the final equation for this equation for Q. I am not going into the further calculations. So here Q would be equal to 4 pi k and t1 minus t2 whole divided by 1 upon r1 minus 1 upon r2. And if we'll simplify this equation, then we'll find out Q is equal to 4 pi k r1 r2 t1 minus t2 whole divided by r2 minus r1. Now we have to write it down in the form of t1 minus t2 divided by rth. So rth would be equal to 1 upon 4 pi k r1 r2 r2 minus r1, and we could write this equation in the form of Q is equal to t1 minus t2 upon rt h, and this is the final equation for the heat transfer due to sphere. Now we will summarize the heat transfer due to rectangular wall cylindrical wall and spherical surfaces. Okay, so first of all, rectangular wall, now cylindrical wall and sphere. So first I will find out the heat transfer Q, and then RTH, equivalent resistance or equivalent thermal resistance. So for rectangular wall Q equal to K minus K dT over dx, so T1 minus T2 upon L. So this is Q. Now for the cylindrical, we have just found out that Q is equal to T1 minus T2, and here RTH would be 1 upon 2 pi LK ln R2 upon R1 and 2 pi LK, and RTH is this one. So ln R2 upon R1 divided by ln, sorry, 2 pi LK. And do you know that it is very important question for the GATE 2016 and 14? The same question was asked, that what is the formula for RTH of the cylindrical wall. So we have to keep these things in mind, that RTH is very important part for the GATE examination as well. And now for the sphere, we have already found it out over here, so I'll not write it down again. So this is it, and in the next video we'll do some questions based on these topics, and we'll cover some GATE questions on the conduction and conductance. Although GATE questions are very easy for conduction, if you'll see these questions, then you find out that HMT is very easy for GATE. And in the next video we'll cover as well the critical thickness of insulation for the conduction, maximum conduction. So what would be the critical thickness, or what would be the thickness of insulation, so that we find out the maximum heat transfer. So thank you for watching. If you find this video helpful to you, then please give a thumbs up. If you don't give this thumbs up, then please do share this video. And if you want to subscribe, then you can, because it's free. Thank you for watching. And again, if you dislike this video, then you could dislike it.